Happy Easter. It's Sunday, the 1st of April, and I'm Biola Alabi. Today's show is all about Arise Fashion Week. We'll be showing the glitz and glam that all happened on Africa's most beautiful runway last night. After which, I'll be bringing you my exclusive interview with British supermodel Naomi Campbell. Stay tuned. First up is Larry Da Silva Ajayi showing. Let's take a quick look.
To succeed, is when I remember a few things.
Shukura kilo kosio, shuku sheka. Yeah, Caroline, save your drama. I don't need it, but it's so for brau. Hola, hola, Mr. Olopa. I'm not there to cause war. Diva, save your drama. You don't need me in your sofa. Yeah, you for there for me. You for there.
Smart team. Everybody knew the truth, though. And everybody kept plan, though. Tonight's the night, make we execute them, though. And as we get fire, light, I mean, I see you when you look on the start of Buga. No good thing come because.
Baby, why do me dirty? Softly.
Da Silva giving us a lot of gold and her signature dance. We look forward to seeing more from her. And she's always at the Arise Foster Show, so you know you're going to be seeing her again at our next one. Now time for a short break, but there will be more from Arise Fashion Week when we return. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back. This is Arise News. You're watching The Morning Show with me, Biola Labi. If you're just joining us, today's show is all about Arise Fashion Week's spectacular show from last night. First, we showed Larry Da Silva's Ajayi's collection, and now we'll be taking a look at Club CGDT and Lawrence Airline. Stay tuned, and don't forget, it is still enough time for you to get tickets for today's show and tomorrow's show. Take a quick look.
Hickory Gaba maldou, bon check up fait par mi tête. Les souvent y ka marché à sous côté devant derrière. Ou ni tchè va sous la même, ou ni la foi ou pas avant. Simplicité c'est mettre bagay, ou toujours des débouchants. Bli souvent assez souvent, ou karete pour la pleure. Mouin pâté à d'un baptême, mouin pâté dans communion, mouin qu'a payé la doise baillot, mouin pâté dans mariage, mouin pâté dans fiançage, mouin pâté dans commérage, mouin qu'a servi à valise. Payer les pots cassés, diri méprisé chaudier, il dit chaudier peut pas tripler, belle prestance et arrogance, bouche en bas, voix personne passable. Thank you.
bati an ba tabla pasa ika le iwe lo o le pe an nou chante
Safuni uku hamba necho mizam Andi safuni mna uku zula Dihlandi nyuka necho mizam Ebu mandini endandi kubo Icho mizam zazitanam Ezi mtungini endandi kuzo Icho mizam zazingeko Ayo ndivile mama Ilizwe lako lalilikulu Nandinga mameli ya bazali bamu Nandinga kata lebi huku mkandwa Kuso zonke sonte zimbi Na kuso zonki ntuenda ndisezi Kia tula mama sandi filema Tula mama sukuli la mama Mato mibomba
Cherry, if you are a cacam, in charity, a quack a cam, in charity, we are high, Jeronum, if we are cobble. Samaraman says somewhere to the more tune the radio. The Samaraman says somewhere to the marking counter graphic. The Samaraman says somewhere to the memmen who there fufu. Samaraman says some obeyed it. You run some panta, docun, war horse, mamma to docun, a manji muqua. Onum, ye banchi. Samama tries in a manji miniature, I'm done my milk report. I say that tea summon aqua ping ping. Yay! Samana qua, horrors, a matizu mana qua, horna, and the pizza mana qua, horrors, a matizu mana qua. Yay! Hibba! Mr. Toonful wants to see a James Brown. And he like your call Gary too much. Get it now. Call him soon. Amada, soon. Brody Tweetwee, so Gary Potoy, so I check it, so a two-way, so Mammy Tree, so Hibba, Mr. A Toonful wants to see a James and he like your call Gary too much. Get it now, call me so I'm a down, so Brody Tweetwee, so I check it, so a two-way, so Mammy Tree. Soul hereby, Tassi Siman, when you are walking the Pudam, why him? So, bear all her sisters, which he didn't know it is. Woman in Yash, something day, woman in back, something day there, woman behind, something day there, woman beside, something day there, waiting day there, ragam, ragam, zoom. Hereby, waiting day there, ragam, ragam, zoom. Look at it one more time now. Woman in Yash, something day there, woman beside, something day there, woman in Yash, something day there, woman behind, something day there, waiting day there, ragam, ragam, zoo. Hibba, day there, ragam, ragam, zoo. The fancy there, we see that you wanna be sure, we see an ayati, be sure, we see that you wanna be sure, we see an ayati, be sure, if not in Osha, where ragam, ragam, zoo. Hibba. If nothing, I'll share where ragam, ragam, zoom. Let's go one more time now. If nothing, I'll share where ragam, ragam, zoom. Catch your name. If nothing, I'll share where ragam, ragam, zoom. My next time, hey, you say loud, motor black and white, dama. Hey, you say loud, motor black and white, some poor. You say loud, I'm black and proud. Be shabby, yeah. On a neighbor, yeah. Work or disco, yeah. Wash a yellow, yellow. Be sieve on a neighbor. Work or disco, wash a yellow, yellow. Walk or ya sing a do. Quad, mama, some of our guys, some of these, mana, papa, who rise, mana, some mana, who is a majestic, and a papa, papa, here, ba. A good one in you, yeah.
Water. myself, this is not my beautiful wife.
Wow, those were some amazing designers and designs, and I can't wait to see what more is in store over the next 2 days at Arise Fashion Week. But it's time now for a short break. Stay tuned, there's plenty more of Arise Fashion Week after the break. Welcome back, this is Arise News. You're watching The Morning Show with me, Biola Labib. We're still reveling in the Arise Fashion Week spectacular event last night. And now we'll be showing you more of what went down. Let's take a quick look at Andrea Iyama and FashPass collection.
Thank you. This room has no boundaries.
Thank you.
Kudos to Andre Yama and Fashpa. It's now time for a short break. When we return, we'll be back to show you my interview with the Arise Fashion Week headliner, Naomi Campbell. Welcome back. This is Arise News. You're watching The Morning Show with me, Biola Labi. As promised, it's time now to show you my interview with British supermodel and Arise Fashion Week headliner, Naomi Campbell.
Welcome to Lagos.
Thank you.
So first of all, I want to congratulate you on the CFDA award that you have coming up.
Thank you so much.
How does that make you feel? I mean, you're a fashion icon after all these years of being in fashion. How exciting must it be?
It was surprising.
Really? Mm-hmm. Unexpected?
Just forgotten. I really don't think about awards. For me, it's just I do want to do my work. And that's really where my mind is. I'm not like about accolades.
Very nice.
It's nice to have it.
It is, and should be recognized.
It's nice to have it from the designers in the American fashion industry.
Yes. Another thing that I was reading about you in Vogue Arabia, you said you're never satisfied. So with all the stuff you're doing,
the context,
and you're never satisfied, and like you're always challenging yourself. You always like to do different things. So it's sort of talking about acting, talking about your philanthropic, and really talking about awards.
It's not that I'm not satisfied. It's like I like to do different things. So sometimes you say something to someone, they write it in the wrong way. It's why I like to actually speak it myself.
Sure.
I like to do different things, things I don't want to have any regrets. I want to try the things I'd like to try, basically.
Fantastic. So you've been associated with Arise Fashion Week for a very long time. It's gone, it's come back, and now you're back. How does it feel to be back and to see so many different
people? This is my first time that I'm walking.
Oh, this is your first time. What about I thought you were associated with Arise Fashion Week in New York.
I've never walked for Arise. This is my first time.
Oh, wow. How does it feel to be here for the first time?
It's not my first time being in Nigeria, but it's my first time walking for Arise in Nigeria.
Oh, well, thank you for coming. Well, it's exciting to have you. With all the fashion designers you've seen, have you seen anything that you're looking forward to in particular, or any other designers that you've worked with
before? I haven't seen anything yet.
Okay.
I'm going to go after here, so I haven't seen any of the clothes or anything.
Do you have any favorite African designers you're going to be looking out for?
Yesterday I met Kenneth, and I love what he does.
Okay.
And I got to go to see Rene's store, Laura, which is beautiful.
Fantastic.
And I understand very much that, I mean, Lagos and Nigeria is very fashion conscious.
Very, very, very. It's the capital of African fashion, if I might say so myself.
Yeah, I can feel
as
that.
As a Lagosian.
It's great.
Yeah. What I would like to know, though, is that I know you've done a lot of work across across the continent. You've been to South Africa many times doing philanthropic work. You've been in fashion for so many years. How do you think fashion can help development and actually address the issues around some of the development challenges?
Yes, I've been doing philanthropy since 1992. I started with President Nelson Mandela in South Africa, not knowing what it was. I didn't know what that word meant, and I just liked working with him and the kids, and just continued and progressed from there. And I can only speak for myself. I then committed myself to wanting to do this, and I liked it, and thought of how I could incorporate what I do as my profession to be supportive in different places in the world. And I have my own charity called Fashion for Relief, and we've done it in India, in Africa, in Russia, in France, in America, in England. So it's basically we address immediate and urgent situations and crisis, as well as education and any type of medical issues with women, children, and babies.
I know that you did some work around Ebola.
You did.
And Ebola was something that Nigerians were very scared of. Nigerians were very afraid.
I think
afraid.
The world was afraid.
Was, yes.
Because they made it into such an epidemic that, yeah, the world.
And especially Nigeria, because our neighbors were being affected. And Nigeria was one of those countries that we were actually able to stem the spread of Ebola very quickly because of quick detection. What was it like for you working on Ebola, which it was really tracking?
Well, I got into that working and wanting to do connect Fashion for Relief with Ebola because of this lovely actor called Jeffrey Wright. Do you know Jeffrey Wright?
Yes, yes.
And Jeffrey basically just like educated me on the whole thing, and I said I really want to help in some way, and so that's how we got involved.
So I know you're running, but before then, since you talked about Jeffrey Wright, the actor, and you've been doing so much more acting now, what is it like? I mean, I love you as Alexandria's mom. What is it like sort of like exploring so many different parts of you? And
I love working with Lee Daniels, and I'm getting ready to do something with him this summer. And it's fun to get to be Lee different. You know, I was like a woman who loved Empire, a younger guy, and now I'm Alexandra's mom, and Lenny's my husband, Lenny Kravitz, with Ryan Destiny, who plays my daughter, and it's a lot of fun. It's a fun set, and Queen Latifah is the producer, and she's wonderful to work with, and just, I've known Dana for a long time.
Are you guys worried that you guys might do a crossover? And
We've crossover of Star and Empire.
Yes.
They've done it.
Are you worried that you and Lucius might run into each other?
I haven't, because that would be confusing, because my character died.
Yes.
So
I know.
I haven't run into Lucius.
But you know, with crossovers,
I think Lenny did a scene with Lucius. My husband ran into Lucius, but I didn't.
Does acting feel like going from runway to runway and designer to design? How do you feel the two connect?
It's different. It's completely different. It's like, on the set, it's much more disciplined, time-consuming, your focus. I mean, everything actually I do, I have to have focus. Otherwise, and commitment. Otherwise, why would I be there? Why would I do it? So it's just, I like learning things all the time and broadening one's mind. And I mean, I studied theatre arts before I started modeling, so it's kind of going back to what I originally started doing when I was a child.
So speaking of modeling, one of the things is the way people are being discovered today. It's so much more different from when you were being discovered. Now there's a lot of models being discovered on social media. There are a lot of people that are starting even younger and younger. What concern?
Well, I think,
concerns?
No, you can't start young.